Hi, David here, F&B Railroad. My last video, I said I couldn't show you how I painted my clouds. And actually, I'm glad I didn't because I've watched some YouTubes, seen some videos, and I've gotten better. So I'd like to show you how I paint my clouds now. Okay, I got my sky painted. And I've got white, blue, and black. And what I'll do is I'll take some white and some blue and I'll mix them together. A little bit of water. Mix these together. More white. A bit of bluish gray. Bit of black. It's a little dark. Alright, when I got a gray I like, I go on and I start in my clouds. Circles, fill it all in, get myself a cloud shape, and that's where I start with that. Now with another tray, I'll go with some straight white, and with that, use a number 6 filbert brush and I load the top of the brush. Leave the bottom empty, load the top. Then I come in on top of my gray and I just start making little cloud marks. Make my puffy clouds. Just pull this white down into the gray and let it mix a little bit. And just keep pulling little circles. And as you see, I take and I start with the tip of the brush and then I roll it over. Puffs of the clouds. Roll the other way if you want. Whatever seems to work for you. Clouds are unique. Clouds are different. I'm gonna go back and start highlighting. The sunlight I'm getting is from the left, upper left, down across the cloud this way. So now I'm gonna start highlighting my edges. And now the brightness of the cloud. Just using the edge of the brush. Some of this, try and blend in a little bit of the harsh lines. Doesn't take much, dulls out. The white will pull easy. Just slightest little bit, giving it a little curl to it. Making some of that dark gray go away. Now for the bottom of my cloud. Not really sure what I should do. I think I'm gonna try going back to my flat number 8 brush. Getting it wet. And picking up just the slightest little black. In some lines. Clean it out a little bit. See if we can't brush these lines up. Some dark. Kind of like that little wisp coming off of there. That looks nice. I think now I'm gonna go back to my Filbert and pull off some more drifters. Last thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put some Stratus. Just barely touched the backdrop. Just get enough. Can't get one laying in front here. Now this is gonna be the hardest one. It wants to, because that gray is still wet, it wants to go gray. And I'm wanting to keep it white. This one maybe. A little bit more difficult. If I let it dry, it'd be easy, but this one, I'm actually turning the brush over and trying to just print the white onto it a little bit. And that's how paint my clouds. Now the thing you gotta remember is the size of your cloud. The bigger the cloud is, the bigger the bottom of the cloud will be because it's more overhead. The smaller the cloud is, the further away from you it is, and the smaller the dark side of the cloud will be. But all in all, this is how I'm painting my clouds now, giving me a lot of 3D depth and dimension. My clouds before, now as we pan around, my clouds. clouds after. So I guess you could say I've got my head into the clouds. Or should I be getting my head out of the clouds? I'm not sure. But thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe and then hit the bell icon to get future notifications of when I put up more videos. Again, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. And keep on modeling.